another episode of Let's Talk About It. And you know what we're talking about? Coming to America. And I didn't know it was not coming to America, too. It was actually coming to America.
Oh.
People were arguing about that on Facebook. And I was like, that's all y'all got to argue about? Okay.
I thought it was coming to America, too. I don't know. Okay, coming.
I thought so, too. It's going to be coming to America, too, for me. Because I don't know. Child, it was too much. Mm-mm.
What's your initial reactions? Did you go with expectations? That's the question.
You know what? No, because I didn't see it as a sequel. I saw it as a standalone.
Okay.
Yeah.
So if you saw this, you didn't see the first and you saw this, you would get it?
No, actually, you're right. Yeah, it's a sequel. But at the same time, whenever I was watching it, I was like, everything from the first one, even though it was matching, I had to go, this is not the first one.
Okay.
This is not it. Mm-hmm. Let me take everything from that and put it over here. Mm-hmm. We're now in, this was recorded probably in 2019, 2020, yeah. Up in there. So yeah. I said, let me have it for right here. Let's see what this is going to be about. So I went in with expectations, but then I had to say, no, don't watch it like that. Enjoy it for what it is and what they did for this one. Because if you're going into it thinking it's going to be like the first one, you are going to be very disappointed.
I didn't have any expectations at all. You know, some people I talk to is like, oh, 30, since 30 years have gone by, you know, they think it's going to be something. I'm like, I didn't think that at all. I'm like, this is coming to America. Like, what the hell do you think they're going, what can you do? Like,
yeah, like,
what you can do with this story. To me, it was like a reunion show.
Yeah, that's why I said I didn't have any expectation, because I'm like, they're not gonna do nothing that crazy.
Yeah, like
it's gonna be very extravagant, very extra, like the first one was. Like nothing about the first one was so traditional. Oh my god, it was so exaggerated, but that's why we loved it. So you know this one was gonna be crazy, exactly. Or even worse, and it was. I laughed a lot in this.
I laughed so much.
It wasn't the same. I was like, nah, this shit was funny to me. I was cackling.
What's the funniest, like, there's a plenty of them, but what was like oh my God, this is hilarious.
The funny part to me was when he said, oh my God, mom, they gonna bathe me. And she was like, son, let them bathe you. And I'm thinking, okay, girl, yeah, because she enjoyed her bath. Next thing you know, this nigga comes for fun. And she was like, I don't think it's clean. Can you do it one more time? He was like, yes, ma'am. I was dead. Leslie, he killed it for me.
I don't really like her, but I liked her in this part.
I liked her. I enjoy her in general, but I thought she was hilarious as the mom. If they picked any, even Lisa, even her, like she had her moments, even when they got drunk together. I thought that was funny. Like,
that was funny.
She had her moments too, but that was one of the funniest parts for me, and even their family in general. And what's his name, Tracy, hilarious, like for no reason. You can tell he's in a scene and he's just gonna take the whole scene. And Wesley Snipes was hilarious. I was dying with his parts, just how they were. I said, oh my god, this shit is hilarious.
It was,
I'm not used to him being like that, so it was funny for me to watch that. So it was pretty good.
A lot of things reminded me of the old movie, like when they brought in was supposed to marry the king. You know, Tiana Taylor, that was her, right?
Tiana Taylor, yeah.
And all the dance, that reminded me of the first one when he met his wife, you know.
Right.
You know? So all of that, and when I said, thank you for releasing the curse from our wife, because she was still walking like a
it was a curse on
him. But then the son did the same thing to his just stay right here. Just stay right here.
I've been waiting here for an hour. That was like, what? Crazy.
I laughed so much. I loved it, you know, again, because I didn't go in any expectations, and I didn't think they were going to make it modernized, you know, like, because we were in the 20s, like, so make it something. This one, what I do like that it wasn't all in Queens. You know, you had the flip side. We in Zamunda.
Even McDowell's. Was McDowell's in Zamunda too?
It was in Zamunda, yeah. I believe it was.
And I said, wait, let me get this. And then they were like, nah, we here to move. I said, let me find out the whole family done up and moved. I said, damn it. Now, when the daddy died in the casket shape, I said, now, wait, why y'all do him like that? Y'all had salt and pepper out here in vogue. That man had a heart attack that quick. That was some, and Gladys, all of that was like.
In the coffin. I was like, is he dead yet? Is he dead? Then I saw his face. I said, oh, he's still alive. Oh, and he want to die.
You know what would have been terrible? If they'd have got the reaction of everybody when he died. Like, that would have been like, ooh. But I know that would have been a bit too much. But to have Morgan Freeman do that whole eulogy, I said, what is going on? All of the cameos.
It was even
Mutombo, like, it was so much.
No, this is just
what? I mean.
I loved it. I was like, when salt and pepper, I was like, salt and pepper?
And then for Gladys Knight to come out, it was a lot. I was like, this is okay. All right.
I loved it. I mean, it's funny, you know, watching at the end of the wedding and, you know, they introduce it. I'm like, come on, sexy chocolate. Come on, sexy chocolate. I was like, yes, sexy chocolate.
Yeah, everybody was like, no. That was hilarious to me. And then for Rev Brown to get up there. No, when they were doing the wedding, he had just church socks on. I was dead. I said, now this, I couldn't take it.
Murphy is hilarious. He's still brilliant. I wonder if people like today would know that all in parts that he was playing in a barbershop. All in parts.
Exactly. Even the dude said, that boy good. He still did it and went with it. I was dying. It was just really... It was really good, and the barbershop scenes were hilarious.
It was funny. I didn't have any expectations, but it's what I expected.
Yeah.
I don't know if that makes any sense.
Exactly. I read somewhere that somebody said the reason why, you know, the culture isn't really digging it for some reason is because it wasn't what they are used to in movies right now, such as a crazy synopsis, but it was just too much. And I was like, can y'all
keep it light. Stop
digging into these movies? Watch the stuff for what it is. If it's a scary movie and it's not scary, just say, well, I didn't find it too scary. It was a thriller for me. If it was a comedy and you didn't laugh, it's okay.
Exactly.
Now, granted, for me, I laughed, and I mean, I laugh at all types of shit, and my sense of humor is very twisted. So for me to laugh, but it's a very sarcastic movie. If you're just going for a joke, like a punchline, you're not going to laugh like that. Even on coming to the first one, you're not going to laugh. If you're looking for da-da-da, they're not jokes. It's like real big type of shit that you just go kiki, and you can keep with you for the rest of your life. It was that tight. Like, even the barbershop scenes, it wasn't jokes. It was like real life. Yeah, it was like jab, jab, jab. Can you get it? Are you going to get it? So it was just, it was good. I'd watch it again.
I'd definitely watch it again. I don't know. People, I just don't know. 30 years, like, what did you expect was going to happen?
Exactly.
I don't know.
The music? Some of the music?
You saw, what you call it? I've seen his face. Oh, he's singer. What? John Legend. Yeah.
John Legend, yeah. When he was doing Queen to Me, I said, I was done.
I'm like, yeah.
I said, Jonathan, now, okay. all right.
So, yeah, we both watch it again. And I mean, I would recommend people to watch. I mean, I'll say watch the first one so you can have an understanding what the heck is going on.
Totally, exactly. Yeah. And I will say that this one was kid friendly too. Like anybody.
There was no sex. Well, I mean, the only.
But it's a good family movie to me.
Yeah.
Anybody can really watch it.
Yeah, because when they was doing a reflection about how he had the bastard son, But they created that story because I'm like, I don't remember this from the first him having sex with her.
Me neither. And the way he can digitally do things now to make him look younger. Because I said, I don't remember this. But then I looked closer and I said, they did that kind of how with Will Smith. What movie was that where he was playing himself?
I I know what you're talking about. I saw it. That's how they did that.
They could do a lot of shit. So I was like, that's how they did that. But yeah, because I didn't remember that. I said, oh yeah, they made that storyline up a little bit. But okay, I'll roll with it. Sure. And I loved how the daughter, at the end, he was able to... I love how the story just went full circle. How I loved that. What is her name?
So with that storyline, how could people not... why would they... Yeah, I mean, just with that storyline alone, you know, woman power.
Right.
You know, woman power.
So I feel like they should have made, even though old dude could marry, you know, his Zamundan princess, that's nice. I felt like the only thing that was missing in this was the daughter for them to wrap back around and actually make her queen or, you know, something like now. Because he wasn't doing shit. So do something with her right now because she was... Okay, I loved it. So I'm sitting here like, why you said, hey, when I die, you can what? Yeah, like. So I like that they hit on that, but I think they should have kind of, you know, wrapped back around and said, here you go, girl.
Do you think they tried to somehow, you know, well, nah, because it's in some wonder. I'm saying, do you think it was trying to do some kind of Black Panther kind of thing? You know, with the fight scene. You know, I was like, are they trying?
I was like, wait, now granted, all through it, she was doing a ha.
Yeah.
I got that, but you're right. It was just out of nowhere. Even when Eddie was telling Simi, you got this, while I'm gone, he came in like, hiya. But I said, what? Okay, sure. I don't know. But then a talking dialogue scene wouldn't have made no damn sense. True. So I guess it kind of made sense, but I was like, I guess this was an homage. But
I like it overall. I really enjoyed it. McDonald, what did he say? And when it was in McDonald's, okay, he was like, he said the McFlurry has the thing on the bottom.
I was like, all these years, and he's still biting on McDonald's, leave they ass alone. I can't take it. Oh, but it was good that everybody was in it, you know, for the most part. Aside from, I think they said the mom was the only one because I think she had passed like years ago.
I don't remember. I remember.
I saw it on Facebook randomly. They were like, I think in 94 or 95 after she did the voice of the mom in The Lion King, she had passed from cancer, I believe. But I think that was the only, and then when the twins came back out, Peaches and my name is Peaches, and I'm
because I don't remember. I'm like, what the hell are these people? I gotta go back and look. I'm like, what the heck are these people?
I don't remember them. How y'all? I think they were just beatboxing while they were going on the dating, dating on the first one. So I don't think they really performed them. But when they brought them back out, I said, what the
they got everybody.
We're like, where is the twins from 30 years ago? You find them, please. Eddie, we found them. Bring them in at the end. I don't know. And then to have Lunel in there. Like, it was a lot of people in this movie. I was like, how did they keep up? What was the budget on this thing? Or were people just excited to want to be a part of it?
Because it's not a low-budget film. Because those are not low-budget people in it. You know, it wasn't like, Black cinema has, you know, they have a Black, some, you know, the regular. But this was big people.
Exactly. Yeah, like maybe they were, even Rick Ross was in it, even though I think they used his house for a lot of the scenes.
Used
the Perry Studios for some stuff. Yes.
That house? What?
Yeah, so a state. I don't know.
But I heard he got like 20 something, like how much rooms in some place?
Too many.
Like how sweet? Why?
Exactly.
You sleep one each day of the month? Why? I don't get it.
And I don't know what type of change he got for that, but I know it was pretty hefty. So I don't know what their budget was for this movie. I have no idea.
They probably made it, you know, because the hype of it, I think they probably made it. Made it back.
I think so. And for it to be on Amazon, I thought that was pretty interesting because everything else has been on Netflix, Hulu, you know, but I haven't really looked on anything for Amazon lately. Like I haven't been like, ooh, I need to go on Amazon to check out SARKAZZ. Like, but this was like, yo, I gotta go on Amazon. But everything I have it. So that was a smart move too. So I don't know how much Amazon was
Made some coins. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So we said it, we'd watch it again. And
yeah.
we'd recommend it. I recommend it. Have you seen it? Let us know and what your thoughts on it. Let us know.
Comment down below. Thank y'all so much for watching. Get your comments in. We'll do a shout out on the next video. We had to jump in and really do this movie because it's been all the rage lately. And of course we had to watch it, but get your recommendations in down below and we'll do some shout outs on the next video. And we'll see y'all on the next one. Bye guys. Yeah.